first Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of the East African Community Affairs, Honorable Rebecca Litwala Kadaga, has tasked parents in Shema District to protect young girls from being exposed to high risks of HIV, early marriages, pregnancies, and coerced sex. Kadaga asked organized women groups in the district, including Mothers Union, to put up programs that will help young girls to make informed choices to live a better life. We have more.
Kadaga made comments while presiding over the International Youth Day celebrations for Shema District and also swearing in ceremony for the District Youth Executive Committee. The first Deputy Prime Minister and other leaders expressed concern over the limit protection rendered to young girls in societies.
I think despite the COVID-19, despite the stress of this situation, we should not abandon our responsibilities. I want to ask the parents to stop their children. I want to ask the Mothers Union of Shema and the districts of Uganda to talk not just to the married women, but talk to the children in the villages where they operate.
Particular reason that I can lay my hands on as to why teenage pregnancies are on the increase, other than lack of social responsibility. Because these are school-going girls that are being impregnated, and they are being impregnated by men in our communities. They are being impregnated by men that they live with, some of them are relatives, by men that they socialize with in different spheres, in church, in school, in the community.
Kadaga also tasked youth leaders in the district to help their peers through sharing information on radios and other communication platforms known to engage in early sex.
But I don't know whether the cow, our friend the cow, do you have money for these young people to go on radio talk to their friends? Maybe if the young people hear a young voice, they might receive the message better than to the senior person. Cow, do you have some money? I really want to ask you to organize some money. Let the young people hear the young voices, urging them to behave, not get involved in direct sex. And you young people, you the leaders, when you're organizing a netball match, first talk to the children about when they live here, they should go straight home. They should not go into corners. They should not engage in direct sex. Talk to them before they play the netball match. The football as well.
On the issue of East African community, Kadaga pledged to engage bilateral meetings with counterparts to make sure barriers that are hindering the development of the country are handled.
The East African community, we have a big responsibility. On Thursday, I was in Utukula, but I found that there's a very huge trade barriers. More Tanzanians are selling into Uganda, and few Ugandans are selling into Tanzania. Similarly, also with Kenya. So I just want to undertake and to pledge to the country that I'm going to do everything possible to engage in a bilateral meeting with my counterparts in Tanzania, in Kenya, in Burundi, in South Sudan, Kenya, so that we clear this issue of the non-tariff barriers that are hindering the development of this country.
Shema Municipality MP Dickson Kateshumwa encouraged the youth in Shema District to take advantage of the parish model setup enterprises that will create for them jobs and income.
To encourage the youth, especially those who have left for urban centers, who are probably looking for jobs, to come back, work with us here, set up enterprises at a village level, at a parish level, and create employment for themselves. If you are looking for a formal employment, the whole government structure employs about 300,000 plus. It is not enough to absorb all the youth who are jobless.
The function, which took place at Shema District headquarters, was attended by MPs from different constituencies and youth representatives in Parliament. Story compiled by Abdul Karim Sengendo for the news in Shema.